Welcome back to Let's Play Hiveswap, Act 1. I'm the RPG chick, and we have this key now. Now we have this key. The only problem is, I don't want to miss anything, but now that every time we get an item, that item could also interact with everything. So we got it from here, this little puzzle, which was not hard at all. Remember when you found this key? Good times, friend. Yeah, it was pretty recently. You couldn't have got this without Buyer's help. Thanks, little Buster. Cute little doofus. Curry, get to the attic. You're running out of time. That's why I do this, guys. It is entertaining. It's just a lot of reading. This is a low-tech analog key, and you're a high-tech digital girl. A girl who needs to hurry the heck up and get to the attic pronto. Hey, that's a great idea. You can dump these off in the attic, the place you've been trying to get to the whole time, and can now enter. Hooray! They really want us to get to the attic. Your dog, last you checked, is safe in their doghouse. You need to get to your Joey house, aka the attic, apparently. Oh wow, the teeth mesh together perfectly. This is... Wait, no they don't. They're just two keys that look nothing alike. Still, it was worth a try, I guess. Kinda. That's right, get steppin'. You've got an attic to be inside of. Put all that nimble grace and graceful nimbleness to work, and get to the attic, quick! Thanks for the help, dear friend. This is the most helpful deer you've ever met. You wish the meeting were under less horrible circumstances. Maybe he could even be alive. That would be fun, to meet a deer that your pa hadn't already killed. Right. Would it have been that difficult for the key to just be, like, hanging off the antler or something? It's not like the monsters even have hands, except the ones with all the hands. Okay, alright, you get it. Now my voice is a little messed up because I read for so long yesterday. After all you went through to get this key, you're at least going to unlock the attic door before returning it to its proper place. If you do that at all, it's unlikely that you will because, jeepers creepers, this was a ludicrous hiding place. You thank the cat for its assistance and quietly apologize for its posthumous participation in this nightmarish spectacle. There were two spelling errors in that sentence. Both shiny and sharp. That's about where the similarities end, though. You can't imagine a nerd swinging a big key around and talking about destiny, but the katanas? Is the little one a katana? Eh, who cares? They cry out to be handled thus. That's not the attic door keyhole. That's a fireplace. They're both holes, but yeah, upstairs. Attic stairway, remember? You've been there before. It wasn't even that long ago. This guy. You nod at the alibi, acknowledging your the silent encouragement he offered throughout your struggles. Your struggles, which are definitely totally over forever. Everything will always be easy and good now. Thanks for the help, Horace. Couldn't have done it without you, probably. Alright. Oh, the clock. Yeah, you were kind of expecting to have to fiddle with that clock to get this bad boy. Weird. You just have clockwork on the brain today, you guess. As one does, right? As one totally does, and that's not anything you should be worrying about. Oh, stalwart champion of the Order of Globe and Lasers, thank you for your noble sacrifice. Noble? Your terrible maiming in the defense of the Apex Tooth Spiral shall never be forgotten. For as long as this message remains on the screen, and possibly a little beyond that, depending on how funny it seems to the player. Wait, what? What were you saying? You mean, thinking? Moving on. No idea, really. That's it, right? Dun, 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 dun. Alright. He leaves the room. Now we look at everything with a key. Well, that doesn't work. Oh, really? They got tired of trying to, put in key text? But all this stuff... I wanted to walk over... Uh-oh. That music's really loud. I have to fight all these things? See, they do have eyes. Oh my. Oh jeez. Hey, wait! I can't do anything. Joey is currently knocked out and has nothing to say about this brute squad. Maybe someone else can help you? Oh. Okay. Shoot the flare gun? The only thing I can think of to do. Oh, I hope it works. Huh. Exclamation marks. Oh. Okay, can I get that guy? Anything you toss in there, you're never getting back. Have some treats. Okay, flash the light. He'd swallow you whole. Okay, we just were supposed to attack these guys then? Positive reinforcement. That was just awful. Electrolyte him up. It's a node from me. Am I supposed to just leave or something? Divertisement. Don't divertis mention it. Putting on the Ritz. No vacancy. Okay, am I... Can I leave? I can't leave. Excuse me? Oh. Oh, no excuses. He took out the other one? What does this mean? Now would be a totally great time for Jude to fire another flare. Okay, got it. Oh, wait. Okay, fire that baby. I guess the same spot? That window is the kitchen window, so I figured that wouldn't be much use. Courage or Frohickey? Langley's Caritas. Hey, jerk! He keeps taking out the other ones. Delighted to see ya. That's so funny. Do I switch back now? Because every time it shows those triangles, we're supposed to switch, I think. Seems to be working so far, we'll just keep going. These aren't particularly intelligent creatures. Don't drop that! Oh no! Oh. Well, now you really got their attention. What does it want to do with the fire? What about this one? Ow! Let's get the frag out of here. What are you doing? Those monsters are coming for you. Hurry, to the attic. I was gonna say that with everything. Do you want to get eaten alive? You don't have time for this. Go, go, to the attic. Am I dead? Game over, wow. Our first game over. Now you realize, guys, this game takes an average of 2 to 2.5 hours to play. But because I'm reading everything and, like, trying to get all the text I can with all, like, possible permutations of messing with things and things, we're going on like 11 hours, I think. Okay, we start off here. Okay, good. The stairs is this way, right? I mean, attic. Alright, let's stop fooling around and go to the attic. What are you doing? Hurry, use the key. Alright. So bossy. But there's a monster in here as well, isn't there? The key fell through the floorboards. Joey, come in. Please report status. Joey, hello, it's Jude. Joey, are you okay, Joey? Please, over. Yes, I'm safe. I'm in the attic. Just barely made it. Phew, over. Locked in, actually. I dropped the key. Safer in attic than rest of house. Key can be retrieved later. Over. I think you were right. The way they smashed through the living room window and the front door... If I'd stayed in my room, I'd be a goner. Separated us with Vanguard. Destabilized power. Probed defenses. Finally attempted entry through multiple points of ingress. Basic siege tactics. Over. You actually know this stuff? I didn't realize you actually knew this stuff. I kinda just thought you just like pretending to be a spy or whatever. We'll take his compliment, over. Anyway, thanks. So I'll just hole up here for now, I guess. Are you safe in the treehouse? Should you try calling your friends or something? Didn't want to risk their involvement. Always a gamble engaging soldiers of fortune. But maybe time. Remain secure in location and ignore object under curtain. Over. I'm not going to ignore it. Well, obviously I'm not going to ignore it. Joy, please. Over. What? It's a big mysterious thing under a beguiling, fluttery curtain. I have to at least peek at it. What is it, anyway? Data insufficient to determine. Over. Well, I'll let you know when I find out. Joey, don't... tect... Seriously, it bent over. You there, go. No. Ordle, it's a really bad time. Over. Jude, can you repeat that? Lots of static. Joey, oh, you took freeze the portal. Did you say? Portal? There's some kind of weird interference. You're getting even more freaked out than you already were, which was severely. Alright, what's this? The handwriting is barely legible, and there's no return address, leaving with you no more information than you had before you looked at it. No, this really isn't the kind of mystery, the boring kind where you have to frequently refer to your rigorously maintained collection of shipping invoices in order to make any progress. You hate those. He seems astonished that this shipment evidently do not utilize the unmatchable power of the avian form, which is a little rich considering it took 3 pigeons to send 2 marbles about 30 feet. It's a shipping invoice, Joey. It's not... You can't eat it. Although you really should eat something, apparently. I should? Am I hungry? Battery not included in shipment. Well, ain't that always just the way? Nope. Nobody ships pogs anywhere. They just appear out of nowhere, like dust or cockroaches. Nothing on this invoice about pet treats. As far as you can tell, you mean because it's pretty faded. But you feel pretty confident it didn't say, ship the enormous crate to this jerk's attic, and also how about those pet treats, eh? And why doesn't this guy raise his dang kids? No, there's nothing about... Oh, wait. Someone scrawled the key. Where is that dag blasted gadzook's key? But that couldn't mean... Okay, so I don't have any scrolling. I have exactly 6 items here. It's crumpled enough without you stomping all over it. With cat-like grace, you totally ignore the shipping invoice. Another victim of Jude's overzealous crowbarring, no doubt. Any chance he gets to go prying and jimmying, that kid just goes nutso. Byers nestles down into the warm straw, the picture of contentment and safety. Beg pardon, Snuggles O. Snoozleton. You were under the impression that this was a team adventure, not the late shift at the nap factory? Maybe you could take a nap in the straw, but if the monsters bust down the attic door, you'd rather not be all tuckered out and ready for the chomping like some kind of kid cuisine featuring an actual kid. You hate kid cuisine. Wait, what were you thinking about? Oh yeah, straw naps. No. Whatever was in there, these would be way too puny to power it. Did I do this one? Yeah. Maybe you could mail them back to... Look, it's time you admit you picked up these pogs of your own free will, and you're only stuck with them because it'd be mean to throw them out. You can go back to dunking on them, and by proxy, your brother, after this. But just this once, you can admit that you saddled yourself with this. Yeah, let's see. Pet treats for food, check. Old straw for bedding, check. You've got everything you need to begin your awful new life as the person who lives alone in this attic forever. You've even got masks and stuff when you get really crazy after a couple years pass. I don't think we have enough treats to last us forever. Weird. You have a strange feeling these are related somehow? Or they once were. It's a hard thought to pin down, and as soon as you focus on it, it's gone. Like a dream upon waking. Okay, so maybe someone was looking for this key and hid it in here at some point? That straw's too soft. You'll never get a good rat-a-tat-tappa going on that surface. The straw has too much give, and in these soft shoes, any rusty nails poking out from the bottom of the crate will go right through your foot. Ow. It's locked, and you're safely on this side. Thank goodness. The door is locked, and you drop the key. The key fell through the floorboards down into... you're not sure exactly. Unlike cockroaches, pigeons are not able to flatten themselves to the thickness of a quarter and slide through the crack under a closed door. There's got to be some salt in this mix, so you sprinkle some across the doorway to keep the monsters out. Not that you really believe in that kind of thing, but you don't really believe in monsters either, and that doesn't seem to be slowing them down any. It's a good thing you had these when you got locked in here. Maybe they'll come in handy. Like, maybe there's a... Well, who are we kidding? There's no way these hefty boys are going to fit anything up here. And even if they did, what good would it do? You're going to scare off the monsters with a battery-powered mummy, swinging a sexy lamp leg around, maybe wearing a bearskin rug and one of those creepy masks while he does it? Maybe he's riding that rocking horse over there, too. That actually sounds totally awesome. You wish you had some markers and some paper and were an artist. You can draw that. This is why I'm choosing all this, guys. Hope it doesn't annoy anyone too much, but I swear, you click the batteries on that door and all those text boxes pop up. Oh, nothing? What the- okay. Really? Does this still work? Alright, I thought it was... Now, this doesn't go to the attic door. That'd be kind of anticlimactic, you think. Not to mention a little too obvious. I think we got that message from the other side of the door as well. You can hear the monsters slavering on the other side. You didn't know you knew what slavering sounds like, but apparently you do. If you went back out there, all the ballet trained dodging in the world couldn't save you. But tapping, there's nothing? Mm. The world is in crisis. If only Captain Planet were here, then the monsters could eat him, and you could escape while they were distracted. Well, turns out you live in a house that has a hand and a jar in it. You must now carry this knowledge with you forever. It's moving. Before I high-five the thing, I'm just gonna interact with everything. Byers, do you realize this globe is broken? No? He doesn't care. You really don't either. Broken globes or functional globes that are obviously inaccurate are just another dumb thing your pa collects, like poor murdered animals or really distracting lamps. No chance of you tracing the spice route to India on this globe, both because it's inaccurate and because that sounds boring. You would say there's no chance this globe needs batteries, but hey, you did just solve a laser-based globe puzzle, so who the heck knows? You drop a pog in a crack in the globe. It rattles around in there like whatever they put in a can of spray paint to make it rattle. Baby teeth, you've always assumed. Baby teeth. You've got a soft spot for injured animals as a junior vet, but a broken globe is not an injured animal. It's just a broken globe. It doesn't get a pet treat. Weird. This doesn't seem like as dumb an idea as randomly using things on other things. Usually it does. It feels like... Okay, this is crazy, but when you hold this key, the globe doesn't seem so wrong, somehow? You put the key back in your pocket and whoa, everybody, get a look at this dumb globe. I don't know what that means. You set it wobbling slightly, so slightly that you can barely see it. You'll just have to take your word for it. Ballet can't fix a broken world, but it does provide the brief illusion that the world has no hold on you. You put this in your attic yourself because it weirded you out that your pa had a lamp shaped like a woman's leg. Little did you know that he'd soon graduate to lamp shaped like entire women. Byers looks at you and at the hand, and he puts a little wing on your hand as if to say, Joey, you do not have to try to use me on literally everything in your house. Nice try, Byers. Let's see what else is in here. Exactly. Ugh, if it comes to that, you'll eat the mummy first. That's not a toy, and it doesn't need batteries. You don't know what the technical classification for a hand in a jar is, but if you had to guess, it seems like a... crime? What was that for the pogs? Well, the batteries. You've got more respect for the dead than that. Even if the dead is just a gross hand in a jar that gives you the max GBs. Right, okay. You aren't really seeing, like, a mouth. The key feels important in your hand, in a way it never did before, or rather, in a way that it always sort of did, but never strongly enough for you to name the feeling, you know, down to your bones, that it matters. It's just sort of... the opposite of how you feel about this jar full of hand. Yeah, and send it toppling to the floor, the glass shattering, the disembodied hand suddenly surging with life as it scuttles towards you, climbs up you and chokes you, probably. No thanks. Not the most graceful partner, but he'd probably be great at following your lead. Hmm. Alright, let me just mess with this, and then I'll mess with the hand. I'll high-five it or something. Yeah. Of course, he thinks it's just great. Listen, pipe down, you. You toss a little spice mix at that leg lamp because, hey, you know what? It's been a hell of an evening. You're not necessarily in the mood to explain yourself. Maybe you just wanted to spice up a formerly luminescent leg and not give yourself the third degree about it. He's our own worst enemy. Maybe this thing has a battery compartment, but you're not going to be the one going looking for it. What? You're going to, like, slip a pog in her garter or something? Jeez, get it together, Joey. You're not into it. This, whatever you're doing here, whatever this is, you're having none of it. If this was one of those weird old-timey lamps from Pioneer times, and if the little turny things on the side of those lamps locked like this key, and if this lamp were missing its key, then you still wouldn't accomplish anything by trying this. Well, darn it. That heel looks a little high to be laying down any percussive shoe rhythms, not to mention a little lonely. The shade does look a little like a tutu, but let's face it, you're reaching. Alright, high five. You've left them hanging long enough. In fact, as you stare at the gross, desiccated hand in the jar, you begin to suspect that the time for you to break open this jar and slap an anonymous dead hand against your own alive hand has tragically passed. Oh, that's a whole box. Okay, I didn't even notice. I thought these were pillars. This is a giant crate filled with hay. All right.